What is up? Happy Friday. Oh, I'm so happy it's Friday. How has your day been so far? While I get this game open. So, just so you know, it is an older game. All games I play are older. Mother Trucker. And it does something real fun. So you're gonna be hearing some stuff, maybe. No, never mind. Didn't cut the sound. Cool. Well, freaking Fallout New Vegas is an old game. Came out like a year after Fallout 3. So just is it gonna? Does it not want to? Oh my gosh! Seriously? Bro. You can't see my mouse, it's thinking really hard. Give me a second. Why not? What is happening here? Bro, give me a second. Apparently I'm really good at breaking these games, so either I have to suck it up and work with what the actual frick? Suck it up and just have my screen messed up. I just got myself banned. Bro, a game I'm not gonna play. Just to let you know. Yeah. So then Fallout 3. So Fallout 3 and Oblivion came out roughly in the same year span. And Fallout New Vegas, which is what I'm trying to play. However, I'm a skeptic, except that my OBS is gonna be effed up. There it goes. Came out like a year after them. Because, so Bethesda, well, Obsidian started Fallout 3, scrapped it. OBS, what's with me and OBS? Bethesda took it over. Then Obsidian started working on this. And then, I'm gonna keep talking because I'm gonna get completely copywritten for this. And, so then, when they released Oblivion, then they released Fallout 3, because that's the pattern that they do. They do Elder Scrolls, and they do Fallout. Elder Scrolls and Fallout. That's what they continually do over and over again. Obsidian took over and started doing this part of it. This game is considered canon. Fun fact. Even though it is technically a different studio, but also the same studio because of timeline, and it's weird. So Obsidian's no longer Bethesda, but at one point Obsidian was Bethesda, and it was just a certain branch. And it was just a little weird. So, like, it's a lot of continuity, but yeah. No, they all came out in the same time zone, because different teams were working on it. And Obsidian was just a team, which is absolutely hilarious. And I am really weirded out over the fact of how different my OBS is sitting right now. I'm just glad I locked everything, or else it would be even worse.
War. War never changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen, under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling, must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
That's amazing. There's Obsidian. Is the volume too high? It says right now I have zero control over it.
You're awake. How about that?
Forget. So, whoa, I'm gonna be mostly blind in this playthrough, by the way.
Out cold a couple of days
I haven't gotten out of main town ever playing this game.
Bearings. Let's see what the damage is. How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
Pervier. So, my understanding of this game is that being an idiot is the best playthrough you could ever experience, and we're gonna do that. I'm gonna make an idiot because that's what I usually do. Screw it. I'm just gonna do my name. I'm not creative enough. Let's do a somewhat normal name. Just in case.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's your name. I'm Doc Mitchell. Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you don't mind, but I had to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out.
No.
I take pride in my needlework, but you'd better tell me if I left anything out of place.
I'm glad you take pride in your needlework, dude. Okay. There, that's as close as a sound check I'm gonna get. Man, I'm actually really excited to play this game. Just because of all... There are so many different endings you can have. Granted, I do not have the DLCs. I can get them later. I just don't have them. Because I don't actually have interest in the DLCs of the older games. It's not this one. This game, I don't know. Customize, eye color, terrain, even though it doesn't actually make a difference in this game. Next, hair color, because I'm not going to change anything anyways. Weight, because why not? And that is as much as I'm gonna get. Customization in this game is both very intricate and very,
Okay. No sense keeping you in bed anymore. Let's see if we can get you on your feet.
Oh, Frick, I'm so excited.
Good. Why don't you walk down to the end of the room, over by that vigor tester machine there. Take it slow now. It ain't a race.
Was broken. I got nothing. I'll have to come back for that.
Good so far.
Okay. Vigor test.
Go ahead, give the vigor tester a try. We'll learn right quick if you got back all your faculties.
Hey, it was only like 6 years, I think. So Morrowind came out in 2002. What year? And okay, 8 years. Only 8 years. But the body models upgraded a lot. Morrowind's face has actually surprised me. Is it because the bodies are just so weird and they for some reason don't have bends in their joints? But their faces were very on point. I think it's very interesting. Okay. Strength is 5, which... Bridge Joe... Well, melee, unarmed, inventory weight, damage, weapon effectiveness? Oh, then yeah. Perception, explosives, lockpicking, accuracy. Hi, Nala. Compass range. I do take my perception very much. Okay, I gotta go over to intelligence. There. Cat look. And look. There we go. That's what our character is gonna be, because I need to be an idiot. Because it's really funny, actually.
Sorry, little lady. I fixed up your head as best I knew how. Guess I missed a spot. Well, we know your vitals are good.
That's a special for you if you're an idiot, by the way.
What do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions? See if your dogs are still barking.
Cool. I will say the character building in this game is very interesting.
All right. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind. Dog.
Kick.
House.
I'm gonna make a psychopath. Burglarize.
Knight.
Shroud.
Bandit.
The Swiss cheese.
Light.
Beam.
Mother.
That's messed up.
Sometimes when you give tests like this, you learn more than you was hoping for, and I reckon that ain't always the best thing. But I guess maybe it explains a thing or two about your predicament. Okay, now I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one, conflict just ain't in my nature.
Very agree.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
No, I disagree.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
Nope, I just am.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
Else.
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
Unfortunately.
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see.
Chemical reaction.
Okay. How about this one?
Ship at sea.
Last
they don't give
one.
The option that it actually is. Head on a pillow.
Well, that's all she wrote. I don't have nothing to compare.
I don't think
there
is ever late to the game.
Just have a look at the results. See if it all seems right.
If there is, I'm 14 years late to this game. But I will say I came in very late to Breath of the Wild 2 and I still haven't gotten very far in it. Energy weapons? No. I want lockpick, signs, and sneak, I think. No. What? Yeah, I want lockpick.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you.
It is a great freaking game.
So I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
You'd be surprised, buddy boy. So two traits. Built to destroy. The flamer that burns twice as bright. Burns half as long. All weapons have 3% chance of critical hit, but equipment condition decays 15% faster. What's Wild Wasteland? Unleashes the most bizarre and silly elements of post-apocalyptic America, not for the faint of heart or serious of temperament. I want to do that, however, I know I'll get my entire butt beat destroyed because I don't know this game. Fast shot while using guns. Do you know what's funny? You can do fast shot and then you can like... Wait, what's it? Less accurate? Which one is it? You can do these two and they like counteract each other half partially. Actually no, they pretty much do. I think it's absolutely hilarious. But yeah. Kamikaze. You have minus... That's so depressing. Minus damage to damage threshold. That's your, like, armor percentage and whatnot. That's so sad. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do the counteract. Because I think it would be a little funny.
All right, I guess that about does it. Come with me, I'll see you out.
Dude. Friggin'... I bought, like, 3 copies of Breath of the Wild, and it wasn't necessarily because I thought it was a great game. It was because people kept stealing it from me. It was awful. I haven't even completed one. So you're doing a lot better than I am. Ooh, actually, I don't want that. These are not steals, so I'm gonna help myself. Okay. Yeah.
Here, these are yours. Was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin. But it was just something about a platinum chip.
Fortunately.
Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this. They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. All got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing
after
what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you. And put this on, too, so the locals don't pick on you for lacking modesty. It was my wife's. I think she was about your size, and she hardly wore it after we left the vault. Felt it was too brazen.
I have only played Breath of the Wild, surprisingly. I got through 2 of the big trials, but then I lost my saves because my Switch got drowned in water, unfortunately. Thanks for patching me up, Doc.
Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for. You should talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled you out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you come right back. I'll fix you up. But try not to get killed anymore.
I'll try. I do not recommend the hardcore mode. Especially for someone who doesn't know what they're doing. So I was gonna complain a little bit. That little opening sequence because I can and I do because I am a me and it was like the New California Republic, the NCR. That makes sense. So like for those who kind of know the US geography, that includes those who live here because I apparently don't know where 15 states are. I found that out very recently. So there's California, which is that big sliver that everybody knows. They call it Everyone knows where Los Angeles is, for some awful reason. There's 2 states that touch it, like, along the side. The lower one's Nevada. That's where we are in this game. So, New California Republic, being in Nevada, Makes a lot of sense. Next to Nevada is Utah. On the other side of Utah is Colorado. Why did I mention Colorado? Vegas is in Nevada. So that's why I'm a little like, why did they mention Colorado? Like, that's like 10 to 12 hours of a solid drive in a working vehicle away. Oh, no sprinting. Stop running, I need to talk to you. Hi.
Howdy, partner. Might I say you're looking fit as a fiddle?
Thanks for digging me out of that grave there, partner.
Don't mention it. I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need.
How'd you happen to find me?
I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up the old bone orchard. Saw what looked like a bunch of bad eggs, so I laid low. Once they'd run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were. So I hauled you off to the dock right quick.
I've never seen a robot like you.
I'm a Securitron. Robco Security Model 2060B. If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says howdy.
Okay, goodbye.
Happy trails!
Okay. So we're gonna go up to that darn bone orchard up there. And we're gonna see what's going on. Bone orchard's such a weird thing to call a graveyard. However, I have quite literally never in my life been to Nevada. However, I'm the only one in my family who has not been to Nevada. My sister was raised in Nevada, so was my biological brother. And then when my parents found out that they were having me, they moved to Minnesota, and I have been here my entire life. So I think it's really funny that I'm the only person in my family who's never been to Nevada. Okay, you found a limited edition Mojave Landmark Snow Globe. These are rare pre-war artifacts that are widely considered to be useless baubles, but rumor has it some collectors will pay dearly for them. So in Fallout 3 and Fallout 4, and Fallout 76, you collect Vault-Tec bobbleheads. In the Mojave Desert, where we are, they collect snow globes, which I think is absolutely hilarious and downright accurate for Southern people. I have seen so many snow globe collections when I was in Texas that it has to be accurate to me. Like, southern states all have, like, the similarity to them, and it's just, like, really weird things, like, there's bobblehead collections, and then there's snow globe collections. My grandparents always, whenever they'd go south, they'd always pick up snow globes and give it to us for Christmas. Me and my sister kept breaking them, so they stopped giving them to us. A bighorn. That's just a mutated bison? Or buffalo? Probably. Anyways, so let's figure out what this town's got to say. Our general store. Hey, hi, Chet.
You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up. The way I heard it, I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps, if you ask me. If you're hurting for caps, I've also got boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for.
What you got for sale?
Can do.
Okay. And I'm millimeter to sell some of this stuff. Don't know what a rebound is, but it's okay. I just accept that. Hollow point. Oh my. Oh, this monster. Okay, so I had this ammo mod when I was playing Fallout 4. A long time ago when I was playing Fallout 4. And I was trying to figure out why there were such weird types of ammo. Like 9mm hollow, round point, round point, hollow point, piercing, ammo piercing. I was like, why are there so many of the same of like different variations? It's because of this mother freaking game. Do you know anything about the people who attacked me?
The leader was a New Vegas type. Typical city boy. He had a bunch of Great Khans with him, probably hired guns. The Great Khans normally stay in their own territory way up northwest on account of them being enemies with the NCR.
I've been to Colorado. Really cool. If you have hearing problems or audio processing issue, don't go to Colorado. Or be used to not being able to hear, because elevation of 7,000 is brutal on the ears. Have you ever been to New Vegas?
Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the strip.
Ooh. Really? I'm happy to hear that. Sorry, I didn't have a lot to say about it last night. I was in the middle of doing trivia. I was over at the brewery helping my mom host trivia. So I was a little distracted in Discord. But I am so excited that you're working on that. It sounds so freaking cool. Like, I don't know a lot about Zelda, but like, I know that Zelda and Link are two different people, so I think that's more than most. That's where my knowledge ends too. So, but I'm really excited to hear. I'm excited you're working on it, and I hope to hear more about it, honestly. Like, the more you like get into it. I'd like to know more about Mr. House.
I'm afraid I don't know much myself. Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules, so I guess that makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. If Mr. House is looking after you, it's gotta be a good thing, right?
Wonder why. Here's a thing. So, this is the first and I think only Fallout game where we're not a Vault Dweller. That is canon. And, we actually have a life in this place. Like, we will actually come across people who know who we are, but since we got in an accident, we're not gonna remember them. Because, you know, bullet to the cranium kind of scrambled our memories. But we're gonna learn more about ourselves and, like, our past in this playthrough if I play this game more. I do know that. Hey, this game has been out since 2010. Obviously, it's not fully blind. I've just never done it. I know enough about this game. Just, I don't know how to do this game. What can you tell me about the Great Khans?
They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems. There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans.
And you never have to worry about that. I'm famous for double texting, sometimes triple texting. It's like, if you have, like, stuff you want to say, if you want to go on a huge freaking rant, do it. I'll read all of it. It just might take me a second. It was like, usually I'm really good about answering a lot of messages. And it's like, if it's, like, in the moment of, like, a creative brain fart disaster, like, send all of it. It's like, if it doesn't make sense, straighten it out later. I'll read it and ask a bunch of questions when I have a chance. But usually it's not because... if I'm not answering, it's not because I don't want to talk. It's usually because I'm literally just really busy.
Take it easy, Discord.
Now. Sometimes I outright just ignore my family. I tell them that. Oh my gosh! So I have a story. No, you're good. It's not just me and my mom who do it. It's through it's a place that I volunteer for that's called the Loon Center. I volunteer with them, and they host the trivia, which is a Loon and Lakes trivia, and it has, like, environmental section, facts about that month, important, like, events that happened. Like, this past time we were doing state fair stuff. Like, you know, just pop culture, like, music and whatnot. There were four of us doing it. My mom was just not feeling well, so it was me and her doing her task together. So, like, I was making sure she was reading her questions on time. I was making sure she had all of her props she needed, and then I was grading her quizzes is all I was doing. I was just making sure she was doing good. She was like, I wasn't focused. People there do not know who I am. So I was like, I can sit on my phone all I want. I just wanted to make sure my mom was okay. What? She was like, it's always a good time to text me. If it's not a good time, I just won't answer. I'll just answer when it's a good time.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you?
Which is very misleading because I'm like all over the board. Like, usually either I'm answering like right on the dot or like it gets really spaced out. But like, usually it's like, send it away. Like, I'll read it. I mean, I run the Discord, so I kind of got to read everything that goes through there anyways. I mean, I do read everything that goes through there. If it's in the public, obviously. Gotta make sure I know what's going on. I'm like, here, where I know nothing. What do you know about the people who attacked me?
The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling the shots.
Very nice suit.
As much as I know. Other folks in town might know more. Word of advice, though.
Cheshire. Oh,
if you ever catch up with him, watch out. The man's got cold eyes like a snake. Can't be trusted, I'd say.
I'm just holding him funny. I was trying to shake him, but he doesn't like being shaken, apparently. Hey, Chesh. Here. Why did I call you? Why are you called Easy Pete?
Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now, we'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and Bighorners.
It is a handsome Cheshy. My Discord goes dead every once in a while. It was dead for like a year, honestly. But, Cheshy. Here's Cheshire. He's all wrinkly. You don't want to be on camera? It's okay, baby. But it was like, freaking, it was hard work to even resuscitate it as much as I can. Oh. Give me a second. Sorry, that was really important. I try not to do that, but that was a call I cannot have a trail. you were a prospector, like digging for gold and silver?
Nah. Means I poked through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging.
Who, Cheshy?
I never liked the term.
Probably. I mean, Cheshy's just friendly as it is.
Salvage means it's broken. Near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, chems, spare parts. Good money in it.
There it is. I lured a head in there. He just sits in the window. It's so cute. I shouldn't say I can't have a trail. It was my mom, but it was stuff to do with my house, and she didn't want it in writing, so. So we've just been going back and forth trying to figure out how to get me to buy my property faster. Is all that was. Which, I'm so freaking excited for the day I own this property. It's so beautiful, guys. What's wrong with the NCR?
Don't get me wrong. The NCR's got a lot of decent folk in it. It's just that they make you part of them whether you like it or not. Towns like Good Springs and Prim don't stay independent for long. Not if you've got something the NCR wants. Still, the NCR keeps the Legion away.
Did you ever find anything good while prospecting?
Nope. Had a pretty good claim once, way out east by the river, but got run off by raiders. Eventually got too old to keep going out.
Tell me about the Legion.
They're slavers, led by a guy named Caesar.
Oh.
Or Kaisar. Not sure how you're supposed to say it.
A couple Caesar of Kaisar.
Years ago, they tried to take over the Uther Dam, but the NCR beat them back. The NCR didn't or couldn't finish the job, though. The Legion's got its strength back and is getting ready for another round at the dam. My money's still on the NCR winning, but you never know. We've been hearing stories about legionaries on the Nevada side of the river, so keep a gun handy. You don't want to get caught by them.
What's so important about the Hoover Dam?
The dam powers a lot of New Vegas, and then there's all that clean water lying in Lake Mead, too. Anybody who owns the dam owns the territory.
Sorry, this dude literally has all of the best information about this game. What do you use bighorners for?
Meat and hide, mostly. Can't put a pack on them. They just lay down until you take it off.
Like a cat.
Find a bunch of wild ones high up in the hills, but gotta be careful around them. They can put up a decent fight if cornered.
Do not stay, or is this pulled tight? Oh, it pulled tight, that's why. I've been trying to figure out why my camera slowly itches away. Has been itching away. So my cube hasn't moved, except for I somehow keep getting on the edge of my camera. Why did I think? I read Most Depressing, and I was like, what, did you just start the story off with him standing in a circle of his friends' bodies? Like, nope, that's pretty depressing. That is, yep. You know anything about Victor?
The machine? Harmless, no matter what Trudy says. She thinks it's hiding something, but I think it's just a broken down relic with no place to be.
Cool, well, I'm gonna go.
Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
I see. There better not be cave crickets in this game. If there's cave crickets, I'm gonna cry. Yep. 9mm pistol. Huh, look at that. Okay.
Cheyenne, stay. Don't worry, she won't bite unless I tell her to.
Doc Mitchell said you could tell me, teach me how to survive the desert?
Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you. Sounds like you need all the help you can get after what they done to you. Meet me outside, behind the saloon.
Cool. Glad to hear it. Man. Oh, hi. Hi, Settler. Okay.
Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles on the fence there?
Now I do.
And try to hit a couple of them. That's the right idea. Look down the side.
Oop, I missed. Oh. That one not hittable? Ha ha!
Try crouching down and staying still. It'll help your aim. Nice shot.
Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles. Tell you what, I gotta go chase geckos away from our water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted
that's
to it.
That's what's at the schoolhouse,
why don't you come along?
Okay.
Follow me. It's just down to the southeast a short ways.
The dog is freaking cute. I can just eat it. I see that. From what I've noticed, you're really, really good about how to express a character. You make very 3D characters very easily. Or games shouldn't. It kind of fail. I mean, this kind of game, you're creating the 3D, but yeah. Do I not get armor? Like, what outfit are you wearing? I like what you're wearing. Can I wear it? Keep running into your dog, Sonny.
Hear that up on the ridge behind me there? We got some geckos to clear out. Bunch of little monsters is what they are. Seems like Doc Mitchell treats more gecko bites than anything else. Let's see if we can get a little closer. If we move quietly, we can get the jump on them. More likely to hit something vital that way.
Okay. I won't pickpocket you, I promise.
Okay, we're on. Go give him hell.
Are you gonna back me, or are you just gonna watch me suffer? Because I don't know what my difficulty is in this game. These bats. Hey, they're ugly. Uh-oh. Damn, it's ugly! What the fuck? Are there any more? Or no? Just the two? These guys are freaking weird. They're kind of cute, though. Did not get any rads from that. They got clean water? This isn't near DC, therefore they shouldn't have that kind of clean water.
There's two more wells that still need clearing. You want, you can come along. It'd be worth a few caps to me.
Timeline-wise, this is like 10 years after the events of Fallout 3. Sure. Which means nothing to some people, but
especially with two of us.
A lot to others.
Come with me.
So, 10 years after Dr. Lee joined the Brotherhood, potentially also 10 years after Dr. Lee escaped the Brotherhood and joined the Institute, and then in 10 years from now is the events of Fallout 4. This is that fun little middle point. Oh, that's a dog. That's a dog. That's... dog has eyeballs on the side of its head? That dog has eyeballs on the side of its head. That's not creepy. How come she gets to sprint? Is that a nerd herd of geckos and something else? God. Who's this?
Hey there. Holy moly. If you hadn't come here like you done, I'd be a goner for sure. I came up here to draw water, but here, you should have what I got. You look thirsty.
Yeah. You're right. I am thirsty, apparently. You have established a reputation with these people. Whether good or bad, you're finally somebody people associate with that group that'll start to react to what you've done. Accept it. Folks have come to accept you for your helpful nature. So, let's see. Where is it, General? I don't know where it is. However, doctor's bags. This is kind of empty, but So I was gonna explain karma. However, karma is a little different in this game. So you'll have different settlements that'll line up, and you can have different karmas in each settlement, whether you're a good person or a bad person, or you can just have an overall. Like if you join, I assume Caesar's, it kind of taints your reputation amongst everyone else.
Now that was some good work. Even got a little excited.
That's my understanding, at least. I know the good and bad.
Here's a little spending money for the trouble. One more thing I wanted to show you. Thought I might teach you about living off the land and making useful things for yourself. Interested?
Couldn't hurt.
All right, then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some Xander root and a Brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen Brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being Xander root over by the schoolhouse. Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking.
Great. Yeah, we should actually probably be marking quests. Oh, it's doing it automatically for me. Cool. Great. So, we were told, unless we want to poke fun or make trouble, don't go near the schoolhouse. Because there's something over there, and I have a feeling it's going to be the equivalent of cave crickets. It's going to be over there, or geckos. Now looking at it, it might be geckos. But yeah, so now we get to go have our fun at the schoolhouse. You know, there's like no kids here. I wonder if Good Springs is an actual town. Cause like this is like a whole settlement, like break, but like good chunk of it's like real places. Like there's like established houses. That's the schoolhouse over there. What are you doing here? Hey, Victor.
Howdy, partner.
Is this your house?
Happy trails.
Victor's shack. You have that shack. He has a cute little home. Where's the radio? That's adorable! He has a cute little home! There is stealing in this game, by the way. Everything glows red when it's ready to be stolen. Are you gonna help me, Victor? Mother trucker. Mantises. I don't kill small things very easily. I miss a lot. Thus. Oh, I broke a rock. Oh, Brock's blade here. Victor, help me. Help me, Victor. Help me. You took a shot to the antenna and didn't die. What the actual frick? What am I looking for here? Am I supposed to go inside? I don't even know what I'm looking for. I have feelings inside. Oh, yeah. Morrowind's so hard to fight in. That was awful fighting. Whee. Schoolhouse. You're pretty accurate. I guess I can kill a rock. Oh, look at those pretty wings. Ow, frick. shoot a mass out of vats, though. Cool. Seriously. Oh, I missed. I don't know how that one hit. What? Okay. Easy. E. Programmer's Digest, which... Oh, I thought this was gonna be locked. Never mind. Up. Wait, what am I even here for? I don't even know what I'm here for. Find Brockflower and Xander Root. Am I not meant to come inside? I'm just getting stuff to sell at this point. Salesman Weekly. Gotta collect all the unburnt magazines. Yeah. Well, that's kind of the case here too. In these games, however, it's just... You usually connect, however, sometimes... you won't take as much damage as you think. Okay, Xander Root. I assume is what I'm looking for, because there's no Brock flowers here. Where the frick is a Brock flower? Or a Xander Root? Are these? Jalapenos? I'll pick a jalapeno. I love jalapenos. These aren't it. Well, how are jalapenos normal? Are they too spicy? Be able to be affected? Can I ask you?
Howdy, partner.
Howdy. I'm good.
Happy trail.
I wanted to ask you about the root thing, but I don't know. Hey, a young bighorner. That's cute. Okay, well, I'm a little confused. So we're gonna go over to the graveyard, maybe. I don't know. Oh, trust me, I struggle with shooters too. Usually. Fallout's the only shooting game that I'm actually good at. And I think it's because Fallout is so weird. You have cactus? Can I have cactus? Just go through the graveyard before I just go try to buy it. So usually I'm better with melee weapons. However, in Fallout, it's just... Their melee weapons are so difficult. Oh, yeah. Oh, come on! Call of Duty. I was never good at it. I don't know why, but it was like Call of Duty, like those kinds of games, like it's kind of weird. Usually I play a shooting game where I can, you know, inevitably just get a follower who does all the fighting for me, and I just do all the looting because I actually don't want to fight. Oh, come on! Y'all, we were up here earlier. Oh. I missed on all those. Hear this. See, I don't like get the entertainment. I don't have joy in like shooting. And whatnot, I get the joy in exploration, is what I get. Okay, rock flower. Okay, goodbye. Get that. It's like my kind of games that I play that I enjoy the fight in is like Stardew Valley, or I mean I enjoy Breath of the Wild, that's really fun. It's like the untraditional fighting is like, and Fallout the shooting just feels In Fallout, the shooting feels natural to me. Like, the weapon consistency seems natural to me. However, like, I play Call of Duty, and it's like, it's not natural whatsoever. The weapons don't make sense. Nothing makes sense to me in that regard. So I was like, I'm just gonna struggle instead. It was like, I play Dark Souls. That makes no sense to me. Like, I understand as like, it's a survival thing. It's a... You die, you die. It was like, the combat literally does not make sense to me. So much that I just don't even fight and I just try to run for it. Okay, so we're looking for yucca root. What we're looking for. I don't know what a yucca root looks like. It's a mantis. Oh my gosh. Oh, Xander Root. Oh, I hate that. I struggled so hard. And it was just right there. Is this a widow plant? Just a widow little thing? Dude, I got so much hate from family members playing Dark Souls. Like, we had this Dark Souls tournament. And it's why I don't actually like playing Dark Souls. They judge me so hard. Cause like I do this, like I treat every game like I'm playing Skyrim. And like I'll just like jump around and I'll scurry around. I treat every game like how I play Skyrim in the beginning. Because I don't know the game. And like I had such a horrendous time. It's like I freaking somehow skipped a boss, got into a higher level area, couldn't fight in there because I wasn't fighting. All I was doing was trying to scavenge and pick flowers. And they were all getting annoyed because I wasn't dying, but I also wasn't fighting. I was just doing crap like this, where I was just wandering around. Ads are really good with that, I see. Anytime I get into a tangent. But yeah. It was just... It's easier just to...
Let me see what you got.
Well, I mean... Yeah, anyone can judge you for how you play a game. Just fine. All right, Twitch is so popular.
We're gonna be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now. Give it a try.
However, it's like, I've watched so many people play games, and they... I've been like, oh my gosh, that's so cool.
That's not bad,
I would love to play that game.
All and it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how. Sometimes it won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. I'm heading back now. Hope I didn't miss anything good on the jukebox. Cheyenne would never forgive me. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy, she's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers.
Okay.
She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi.
Okay. So we gotta go meet Trudy. But... No, it's like, I just accepted that I play games a lot differently than people. Therefore, like, when I watch someone play a game, usually when a new game's coming out, I'm trying to decide if I should spend the you know, $50, $60 to buy it. I usually watch someone play it. And it was like, I've gotten so many people like, you shouldn't do that. It, like, spoils the game. You just should read some game. Like, but I don't know if I like how it plays. Like, if it feels like I'm driving a character like a bus, I usually don't enjoy it. It's like, that was actually one of my main complaints with Assassin's Creed when I played the second one. It was just how, like, weird the character moved. I just didn't like it. Hey, Peppers! How's it going? But yeah, no, it was just like, I have to watch it, but then I end up playing it differently because I choose the most chaotic route, and then the game's completely different. I don't know what's going on. And I still get a good fun out of it. It was like, I've seen the lore videos. Seriously? Five? That's... Jesus. That's awful. But yeah. Man.
I'm done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
What the hell is your problem?
Hey, Trudy.
Well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon.
That looked mad. Something going on?
Looks like our little town got itself dragged into the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Jeez. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him.
I thought that Cobb wasn't able to find Ringo. Town's not that big.
Cobb hasn't exactly been looking for Ringo too hard. I think he's afraid that Ringo will ambush him, which is probably true.
Where is he now?
He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill.
Ooh. Why not just kill Cobb and be done with it?
You mean murder him? That's not our way, even if Cobb is scum. He can bluster and threaten all he wants.
What are you gonna do?
Some of the others, like Sonny, will probably stand up for Ringo if he asks for help, which he hasn't. Personally, I hope he sneaks out of town one night and takes the Powder Gangers with him.
Powder Gangers?
Chain gangs, really. The NCR brought them in from California to work on the rail lines. Problem is, it turns out that giving convicts a bunch of dynamite and blasting powder isn't the best idea. It was a big escape not too long ago. Some of them stuck together so they could make trouble. That's what we're dealing with now.
Dude, ads freaking suck. However, Twitch is kind of not reliable, you know, for ability. I say that, and eventually my stream will just crash. Watch. It'll happen. Never mind, I want to talk about something else.
All right.
What do you got for sale?
Got a special discount.
Cool. A varmint rifle. I love a varmint rifle. Stealth boy. Super stim. Wow. Man. Hope she has enough for this. Don't think she does. Look at that, I got money! And she's
broke.
Give
me a shout if you need anything else.
What happens if I help Ringo?
If you were able to get Ringo out of this mess, you'd have a decent reputation around Good Springs. I'd even set you up with a discount. Of course, helping Ringo would also make the Powder Gangers mad. And they've got a lot of friends out there.
So if I help Ringo, Good Springs will like me more. What if I help the Powdered Gangers?
Don't know why you'd want to do a thing like that. Yep, you'd get on their good side, but people around here wouldn't appreciate it one bit.
Watching the what? I don't know why you are. I'm trying to track down the people who attacked me. Do you know anything about them?
Not much, other than they're a bunch of freeloaders who expected a few rounds on the house. I was able to get them to pay up, though. Of course, one of the great cons did knock my radio to the floor by accident, and it hasn't been working since.
Did my attacker say where they were going?
They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. Sounded like they came in from the north through Quarry Junction. If that's the case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back.
Why is that?
That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them.
Oh.
Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive.
I see.
Which it could be for all I know.
So where were they headed?
I didn't hear exactly, but the leader was talking about the strip. Fellow wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up.
Okay. Can you probably fix my broken stuff?
Sure. The outside looks okay, but I think something broke on the inside. There'd be caps in it for you. I do like to hear what's going on in the world. And that Mr. New Vegas seems like such a gentleman.
New Vegas? Mr. New Vegas. Cool. Well, I'm gonna go.
Be careful out there.
Okay. So let's go talk to Ringo. You know what I learned? That one of the Beatles was dyslexic. That Lennon was dyslexic. Oh. I don't know if I just rested my finger wrong or something, but whoopsies.
That's close enough. Who are you, and what do you want with me?
Not an enemy. That's what you're asking.
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan? You know how to play?
What he does? I know that Chris Pratt or whatever tried to voice Mario and just used his normal voice because he's not a voice actor, but I didn't know Danny DeVito did Mario. What? What are the rules of Caravan?
It's a two-player game, and the winner takes the whole pot. You build a caravan using the cards in your deck. The goal is to create caravan bids that beat your opponent's bids, so there's more strategy than luck involved. It's why you won't see Caravan in any casino. Too slow-paced, and more importantly, no house edge. Here, take this holotape. It goes into more specifics about the rules. You'll also need a deck, so take one of my spares. So, you feel like playing a game?
Let's play.
Don't worry. I'm not that good of a player.
What the fuck? I'm so confused. What? I'm so confused. Man, I don't know. Yeah, I don't think I want to continue with that. I'm going to figure that out later.
What is it?
I want to figure out why Kyle's looking at me. I'm so confused with it. I need to figure that out.
He doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight.
Who voiced Parthenax? What? I don't know who voiced Mark. I never know who voices anybody. I don't know voice actors. Except for Tara Strong, but that's because she did my entire childhood. Literally the entire thing. What are you gonna do about the powder gangers?
I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own.
Maybe I can help?
We'd just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us. Now, if some of the other people in town were also on board...
I'll ask around to see who I can round up.
Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
Okay, I want to figure out this. What's up with the holotape thing? Wait, is it notes? This is going to be notes, isn't it? I don't understand this. Oh, I'm going to have to read that? Oh, screw that. Yeah. Go find Sunny, then. Man, I don't want to read. I'll play Caravan later, though. Dude. Frickin'. You know what I think is hilarious? I remember, since this is a gambling game, since Vegas, everything's about gambling here. I remember growing up, and there was the Super Mario Bros. Like game on the DS, and it had like the little mini game, whatever. And they teach you how to play blackjack as a child. Freaking, I am great at blackjack. No one plays it with me though.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
I need help, Ringo. I'm gonna help Ringo take on the powdered gangers. I might need your help.
Say no more. I'm in.
That was easy.
Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo. But I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with. A lot of people around here look up to Trudy. If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere. And Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well.
Cool.
Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great.
Any ideas how to convince Trudy to join us?
A silver tongue would help. Convincing Trudy that we had a good plan to win the fight would also help.
Cool. Would Chet be willing to give us the supplies?
I don't think give is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake... he'd still make you barter with him.
How easy can I get Pete's dynamite?
Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before
not
you
easy.
Hand it over.
Okay. Let's just try this. Oh, frickin' hell, where'd she go? Rudy! Okay, well, let's hit Easy Pete first. Since we all know where Easy Pete is, he's rather easy to find.
Howdy.
Out of there. I hear you got dynamite. It would help us beat the powder gangers.
Too dangerous. Gonna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it. Better to leave it buried. Safer that way.
How can it be? Just light them. Oop.
Too dangerous. Sorry. Blow yourself up. Blow your neighbor up. Blow the whole town up.
Frick.
Yeah.
Okay. How about Chet? Let's go talk to Chet. Hey.
You looking to buy some supplies?
I need supplies to fight the Powdered Gangers.
Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the Powdered Gangers. That's a 1,000-cap investment you're talking about.
Okay, so that's a later thing. Okay.
Right.
So, we're just gonna...
The other casino...
Move on.
Take it easy.
For now. We'll come back here. We'll come back for them in a bit. I guess. Okay. We gotta get to Prim, though.
I'll keep an eye out for the Powder...
I need to get to Prim. Can you suggest a route?
Sure can. Take the road southeast out of town till it hits the freeway. Prim is a town with a roller coaster straight south. Can't miss it. NCR patrols do a good job of keeping the highway clear, but I'd keep your gun where you can reach it easily. You never know who you'll run into.
Okay.
Off the road, you'll probably start running into hostile wildlife. My advice would be to stick to the highway when you can.
Cool.
Until next time.
Okay. So, did a quest. Went of that away. Evening, sir. Okay. Frick, M does not work in this game. I forget. You're too old. The Ghost Ring Sword. So we're just gonna follow this up. Oop. We're literally just gonna follow the road. Cool. This is a rather cute game. Oh, hi. What do you want? Hi.
What do you want?
It's my line. What's been going on in the rest of the wasteland?
Same old shit that's been going on for years. The NCR and Legion are still fighting over Hoover Dam for some reason.
Okay. Goodbye.
Yeah.
I don't like gangers. I don't know. He seems like trouble. Oh, my gun's gonna break. Let's switch over to a pistol, I guess. I don't got much ammo for that, though. So we're gonna hope for the best. We're gonna hope that if we stay on this road, that nothing bad will happen. However, can't really promise. Since it's a frickin' wasteland and we're in a desert. However, where we're going is, like, right over there. Okay, but we are gonna be getting to our original home office. Oh. Finish. Cool. So Vegas is that way. Prim that way. And we can get some pants up that way. But psh. Quick save a little bit. Oh, they're friendlies. What do they got? You've discovered several locations. Cool. Cool. Fabulous. Barter, explosives, guns. Black Widow.
You eyeballing me?
No. This is how you know it's stolen, by the way. Yeah, it's all red. Cool. I'm in limbo with them, apparently. Bridge. Here, we're gonna just play with this gun until it breaks. Man. Freaking geckos. Where's the NCR? Freaking love Black Widow. It's one of my favorite perks to pick. Fricker. Goodness gracious. Yucky. Oh. What's that? Is that a scorpion or something? So on the compass down below, because this is an older style compass. Those triangles all mean that there's locations up ahead. Oops, I missed. Okay. This. Is this an NCR camp? There's friendlies ahead. Oh, NCR.
Hey, where the hell do you think you're going? Prim is off limits.
What's going on?
Some convicts from the prison up the road have taken over the town. Everyone inside is either dead or in hiding. What's more, there are two tribes of raiders causing trouble in this area as well. You'd be safer heading back up to Good Springs.
Shouldn't we be protecting the town or something?
We'd love to, but they don't fall under NCR jurisdiction. Even if they did, we're in no shape to protect them.
Thanks for the warning. I can protect myself.
It's your ass. Don't say you...
Cool. This is it. It's they're over there. I think. I'm pretty sure, at least. Yeah, he's got people here.
It's been a long tour. All I can think about now is going back home.
Why does her voice sound familiar? Okay, we're gonna quick save here. Oh! With a bat! Yep. That was a nothing for healing. Yep. Okay, so we got some convicts here. I got my gun breaking. And we gotta figure out how on earth to get into my home. Mojave Express is where I work, by the way. We gotta kill some fools. Yeah, happy Master! Nope, Vermit's guns don't do much for Vermits. Oh, that's rough. Okay. Get back here, frickin' wuss. Atrocious. What's my next point? That was awful.
I don't know what it was brought you to Prim, youngster, but you might want to rethink your plans.
Time's going to hell. Motherfricker. I got some questions about Prim.
Well, I'll answer what I can.
There you go. Okay. Sorry. It was on my phone when I was making sure. I can't see any of my stats. Do you know where I can find the courier office?
Sure do. I run the courier office out of my shop. Leastways I did before things went to hell around here.
Oh, I'm a courier with Mojave Express.
Well, I don't got any work right now, sorry to say.
I lost a package I was supposed to deliver.
I'll tell you whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me?
What can you tell me about this job?
Oh, so you're talking about one of them packages. That job had strange written all over it, but we couldn't turn down
I'm getting
cash.
Copywritten. 1 second.
Don't go.
Is there a... Yeah, find it. Is it just playing? It's just playing. Okay, we're screwed.
Hey, youngster.
Okay.
Still hang.
Yeah. What's strange about it?
That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers. Each was carrying something a little different. A pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I have in the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in.
He canceled?
Yeah, got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real. I said sure as lack of rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job, just like that. I asked if he was sure it was good money. No, let Courier 6 carry the package, that's what he said. Like the Mojave'd sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out.
You know who he was, where he went?
No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that, and turn down the money too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name
was shot in the head.
Luck. Not for me to
Ain't
say.
Ain't that a kick in the head? Well, some men stole my package. A man in a checkered suit and some thugs. Did they pass this way?
Well, now that you've mentioned it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them Great Khan misfits. They was talking about a chip.
One of those men shot me, and you know the best way to get to them.
Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Beagle. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on them, and he was slinking around Bison Steve when your pretty boy friend came through.
What are
he may have
names?
Heard where they were going.
Why was my name strange? Freaking Bison Steve? What? Can I ask you something else?
I guess I don't have anywhere better to be.
Can you give me a, actually, what do you got for sale? Hockey mask. That. Okay. Okay. Empty out all this junk. Okay. Five NCR dollars. What? I need 9mm. Do you have ammo? No, of course you don't. Okay.
Another satisfied customer.
Okay, let's go. Hey, Princelin. Is that a bag or are you pregnant? I'm gonna just go. Been captured? Man, I don't think I'm capable of doing this. Oop, crap. Ah, mother fricker. What so many of you guys? Oh, frick. Oh, shoot.
Had enough?
I don't think so. Why are so many mother frickers? Okay. I wonder where they're keeping Deputy Steve. Maintenance store is easy. That's not where they're keeping Deputy, whatever. Frick. Goodbye. Goodbye. Run fast as you can. Can't catch me. I don't have broken legs. Okay. I'm gonna go stand behind the NCR guys a little bit and do a little inventory checkaroo. Freaking, they got another one. Hi, buddy. Okay. Leather armor. Gonna be best bet. That's 6. Trooper helmet. Okay. Dynamite. Okay. Incinerator? Flamer? Okay. Wonder if I heal if I wait. We're gonna find out really quick. No? Okay. Okay. Then we're gonna go over to Good Springs real quick. But I accepted. I need to go somewhere where I'm not causing problems. Be able to figure my crap out. Where's Trudy? I want to sell to her, but I can't sell to her. Okay. Gupta. Oh, come on. Is it because it's a crazy time of day? Why is the store locked then if it's a wacky time of day? Hey, Chet.
You looking to buy some supplies?
Yeah, in your doorway specifically.
Can do.
Okay. Cleaver, fire iron. Sell that stuff. He doesn't really. He seems to really help with. Doesn't really help with anything, honestly. Okay. Ammo. 9mm. Okay. Kinda. You got aid. Yeah, 4 to even 1. That's awful. What can I get for those? I can get 1 stim pack. Energy cells. I'm never gonna be using those. Well, I'm not gonna be using them for a very long time.
Another satisfied customer.
Not necessarily.
Take it easy.
I'm just another broke customer. Okay. Doc! Help me. Help me, help me. I got a bullet in my leg, Doc. I wonder if he'll fix me for free. Now I'm gonna go rob his house.
Welcome back. I had hoped you wouldn't need to come see me again so soon. What can I do for you?
I hurt, Doc.
Don't look like...
Okay. Broke and hurt. Thanks. Darn. Okay. So, let's go deal with their... See if we can deal with the people here, actually, while we're in Waitsville for that, because I feel like we'd get decent benefits and we leveled up, so... Let's see if we can get some help. Mother fricker.
You looking to buy some supplies?
I need help. 25.
You made your point.
Thank you.
Provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand.
Okay.
Take it easy.
Dynamite. Hey, Easy Pete. I love calling Dynamite Howdy. Bill. Dynamite, please.
Told you before.
I'm familiar in handling explosives and dynamite included. Okay. What do you know about Joe Cobb?
Bad trouble.
That's helpful.
Welcome.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
I'll keep an eye out for...
Okay. Cool. Do you know where Trudy is? Oh, now she's behind the bar. Cool. Hey, Trudy.
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
Sure I do. Ah, frick, we're a little outnumbered, but I can't because I can't talk to you because I didn't level up speech. Near this loon and the sore are good spots to stage an ambush if I had the help.
That does sound like a good plan. All right, you seem to know what you're doing, so you can count me in. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
Okay. Then, let's go talk to Sunshine or Sunny or whatever.
I'll keep an eye out for the powder.
Oh, I don't need to. What do I do next? I don't have that quest equipped. This. I assume I go talk to, what's his face? Oh, Doc Mitchell. Still gotta talk to him. Right. Hey, Doc.
How are you holding up?
Town's gonna be attacked by bandits. Anything you can do to help?
Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone. Oh, I'm not much good in a fight with my bum leg. And my supplies are scarce, but I'll give you what I can spare.
Thank you.
You take...
Okay, now let's go talk to Ringo. So, we have hit all of the optionals, so I think this will go pretty good, personally. Hopefully.
Hi. So what's going on? Did Sunny agree to help us?
Sunny's with us.
Well, I guess that means we're ready to go. Unless you think there's something else you can do.
Let's do this. I don't think there's anything else we can take care of.
I hope.
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play.
How many?
At least 6. Joe Cobb included. They look pretty mean.
This is pretty fun.
Easy Pete came through with the dynamite. Here's your supply. I really hope I don't blow myself up. I'll be set up near the store. Let's hope that the gang doesn't manage to make it that far.
Cool. Frick, that's intimidating. Call a freaking flamer. Incinerator, my bad. Which is better? I never even looked. Cool. People just hidden everywhere. Search all these people.
I owe you a huge favor for this.
Holy frick!
Here, these are technically Crimson Caravan funds, but I know they'll understand once I explain things.
You're welcome.
I'll stick around for a bit longer, but I'll be gone in a few days. If you ever visit New Vegas, look me up at the Crimson Caravan camp.
Cool. Jays. I got supplies now. Your whole cob kind of just exploded, huh? Okay, what do we have going on here? Jeez. Okay, single shotguns. Magnum revolver. Cool. Jeez. And Stimpax. Ooh, the... Aw. Go for a bike. Can I talk to Sunny about that?
That'll teach the powder gangs to avoid good springs in the future.
Oh. Okay. You're brainstorming.
Look at him.
Dang.
I'm glad that business is over. I like it when Good Springs is nice and quiet.
Me too. What do you got for sale? Okay. Rick. Sell that. Keep this just in case. That can go, definitely. Okay.
Thanks.
I'm not taking sides.
Okay. There! I think we're doing a set a little bit prettier. Now go do that. Holy frick. I don't know what I was expecting, but like, I did not expect this gun to shoot like that. Daniel Wand. Okay. Five. Which makes sense. Direct quotes would help. I think it'd make the story feel familiar, at least in my opinion. Cool. Oh, this goes a lot better when you use a gun you're not supposed to have. Jeez. Okay. Survival. Medicine. What I want. I need to get repair up though. Deputy Beagle?
Why are you? I'm in a bit of a predicament.
I'll set you free.
Oh, that's just my.
Stick with me.
Oh, that's so gracious of you to. Please excuse me, I'm extricating myself at the moment.
Yeah, that's fair. I gotta talk to you anyways. I accidentally set the man on fire. I'm so glad he's not mad. Maybe he's a little mad. He doesn't like me.
Hey there.
Well, that was quite an adventure. We taught those convicts a thing or two, didn't we? Breaking myself
sure
out
did.
Of a hostage situation. Not to diminish your role in it, of course. But it was quite thrilling. Problem is, there's still no law in Prim. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage?
Tell me about the man in the checkered suit who came through here.
Ah, yes. My memory is much clearer now that I'm free from my bondage. I was performing recon, gathering information on some of the powder gangers, when some great cons arrived with your friend in the suit. They were talking about some delivery they took from a courier. I assume that was you. They said they'd be heading through Nipton to Novak to meet a contact there.
Cool. What am I still doing, though? Protecting the town.
Hello again.
What are you talking about? You're sheriff now.
Oh, no. I'm just a deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command.
Yeah, but the chain died. What are the qualifications for sheriff?
It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the powder gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already.
Yeah. Okay.
Maybe next time you...
Cool. I want the NCR to do it. Yeah. Okay. Hi. The crew of the convicts. So they just have to maintain it. However, give me 1 second. I need more water. It's very rare that I finish my water, that I drink an entire water bottle. Who E? I have so many of these water bottles. I freaking love them. Alright, let's give that hard save just in case. There. Okay, let's go talk to NCR.
Been a long tour.
Long tour. How do we make this place your home? The amount of times I've nearly blown myself up just walking across that bridge is astounding. Man. Okay, is this the dude in charge?
We won't. Careful. Thing. You lost?
Yeah. Vigo wants a new sheriff for Prim. He suggested ex-sheriff at NCRCF and NCR potential candidates. NCR Correctional Facility? Ah, frick. Vilified there. So I'm gonna have to kill them if I go there. Let's try this. This gun is crazy! Frick, I love it. Okay. Well, they're dead. From who? I already killed the guys. What was that voice? What? What? Okay. Where am I going? So straight through this way? Relax where? Ooh. I'm gonna be so sad. I'm gonna have to switch weapons. What is this place? Gene skydiving? You still open for business, Gene? No? Okay. Frick. Okay. I don't want to go someplace I'm vilified at. Screw that. What does that have to vilified at to ask for help? Like, seriously? Ooh. Are these all the quotes that you're using? Lieutenant Hayes?
I'm Lieutenant Hayes of the New California Republic Army, 5th Battalion, 1st Company. What's your business?
Prim is in dire need of some real law.
We know Prim is a great strategic point, and we aren't blind to the needs of the town, but we're barely holding our own against the powder gangers. We don't have the guns or the personnel needed to carry out our mission, much less take on defending this town as well.
What do you need to take over protecting the town?
What we need more than anything is bodies. If we had just one more squad, we could easily install a sheriff and still handle our primary objective of protecting the interstate south of here. If you'd like to see the NCR include protection of Prim and its duties, then you'll have to get some more troops up here. Knight at Mojave Outpost may be able to help.
Okay.
Ma'am.
sir. That is the Mojave Outpost. Oh, my Atlanta. Okay. Can I drop pointers? No. Okay. Definitely not that way, so we're going that way. Oh. We're adventuring pretty freaking far for this town. It's not even that far, this map's just not that big. But... you know, it's really fun. Is this the road I need to be on? Sure is, I think. Yeah, the other one, that one just circles back around, I think. So, oh, freaking weird. The person up there. Oh, it's a friend. Those aren't friends, though. What are you? Convict. Cool. And now I'm out of ammo. Great. What's this place? Nevada Highway Patrol Station? Seriously? I'm assuming that's where I'm going. Not far enough in this game to not be using bats. So unfortunately, it's taking less ammo. Big hill. My layer. Is this actually it? I think this is actually it. Too many crickets. I went through like half my ammo just trying to get here. It better help. Goodness gracious. This is a really cool statue, though. Oh, it's paper mache! It looks like... Oh, I have an outpost.
Hey, coming from the north? Must be crazy to brave those roads.
What are those statues of?
Those two? Represents unification. Mostly good for shade. Won't do much else when the Legion reaches us.
Why are they not going? That's rude. Oh, hi. That's really sad.
Hello.
Oh. Hi. What? Why was that so delayed? I'll be going now.
Watch yourself.
That's out of order. Okay. Well, thank you for donning me with your wonderful outro. Hey, Prospector. You're a trooper. No, you're good. Major Knight.
Caravan, citizen, pilgrim, or...
Request. Citizen, I guess?
Just need something for the logbook. Keeping tabs on traffic throughout the outpost. Although mostly just in, not out these days. If you're looking for the commanding officer, he's in the back. Although, he's got a lot on his plate, so if you speak with him, keep it short. Also, if you need any gear checked, we can get you up and running again. Once you fill out the work orders and sign for the parts, of course.
I need to talk to you about Prim.
Prim? Hayes units are stationed up there. We're having problems with some of the NCRCF convicts. What can I help you with?
Prim is under man and is requesting additional support.
I'd like to help. We can't spare any more units. We have to maintain a minimum headcount at the outpost. Orders from the west.
Having Prim and the trade route under NCR control would help the West.
I see the wisdom in that. I'll radio for a unit to head up to Prim and offer some additional support.
Thank you. I need I don't need repairs. I need ammo.
Ma'am?
I'm enjoying the quotes you're throwing at me. So, I mean, keep them coming if you want. Okay. Frickin' wow. So how far around the map have we made it? Halfway down? Jeez. Oh, this is the strip. Look how beautiful that is. Look how big that is. Ooh. Okay, Prim. Okay. Let's go talk to what's-his-face now. I'm not going to a place where I'm vilified. I'm not going to the correctional office right now. I do not have the power, strength, or health for that. I'm trying to get as many safe places to go as I possibly can. And if they get Prim up and running and trade functioning here, frick, that would be nice.
Yeah.
Okay, I got extra support for.
Yeah, I just got word of that. There's a squad of Rangers standing by. Sergeant McGee will take over as sheriff, and the Rangers will be his deputies. This town will be in NCR territory. This means that aside from protection, the citizens will also need to become registered NCR citizens and pay any appropriate and associated taxes.
Yes. Tell the troops to come protect Prim.
Roger. I'll radio them over now.
Cool. Then I'll go talk to what's-his-face that NCR has taken over. Oh, frick yeah. Leveling up is really actually kind of easy. Speech. Medicine. Howdy, mister. How's it going? I'll throw one to survival. Cannibal? Cool. Intense training. Okay, endurance. Oh, heck yeah! I freaking love hatch browns. How was your Friday? While watching me completely fail in a Fallout game. Nope, this is completely vanilla. I can barely get the game to function, man. I don't think I can get mods working right now on this game. It sends my other, this game sends both of my monitors into havoc. So I'm a little afraid of the mods at the moment.
If it isn't the Lawbringer.
What's your problem now?
My problem is that I'm no longer a deputy. I'm just a beagle now. Apparently 2.5 months of law enforcement experience doesn't count for any. He's rude. Don't tell him I said it. Prim has a sheriff now, just not as supportive as I would have hoped.
Yeah, well, dude. Freaking sucks. Sucks to suck, huh? This place is really glitchy in here. Like, if I get to know the game better, I might mod it, but I also haven't played Fallout New Vegas on my own before, so I don't actually know a lot about it. Maybe. It might also be my computer is barely functioning right now, so it's probably killing a lot of the graphics as well. I also don't have the DLCs either. Because I am playing as I go, if you will. What do I got going on now? They want that away? Ah, frick. I don't want to go that away. Nipton? Nah, I got partially there. Okay. What was that? Okay. So we're just gonna be miserable, do the world's worst thing, and stay off of the highways. And hope. Motherfricker. That I don't get murdered. I'm not confident. Whatsoever right now. Things come after me, I'm just gonna keep walking. Frick, I'm walking straight towards things. Frick, screw this. Oh, they're ants! They're ants, ew. Man, I wouldn't be able to say things like that. I can say that in Fallout London. I can't say that in any of the other Fallout games. Oh, frick. Keep walking, keep walking! I'm not a strong character. Like, freaking, I want so bad to go to Nevada with my sister. Just so, one, I can see her old playing ground. Two, so I can like go places and be like, don't touch me there! Not that. I'm scared of the ants that are right behind me and I'm afraid to look. And say things like, oh my gosh, look, it's this place! What's this place? Where am I? Nipton? Please tell me this place is friendly to me. Is this Caesar?
Yeah! Who won the lottery?
Oh, this motherfucker!
Smell that air! Couldn't you just drink it like booze?
I think you're right. I think this place is nuts. What sort of lottery did you win?
What lottery? The lottery. That's what lottery. Are you stupid?
Yep.
Only lottery that matters. Oh, oh my god. Smell that air.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Just so y'all know, my character literally has one intelligent point. So my person is quite literally stupid. I need to get going.
Bye.
I think that dude's gonna be like the bottom of the line. He... Oh, what the frick. What the actual... Oh, this is Caesar's place. What the actual frick is this? I'm scared.
Don't worry. I won't have you lashed to a cross like the rest of these degenerates. It's useful that you happen by. I want you to witness the fate of the town of Nipton, to memorize every detail. And then, when you move on, I want you to teach everyone you meet the lesson that Kaisar's Legion taught here.
Kaisar?
Especially any NCR troops you run across.
It's Caesar, man. I'll do as you ask, okay?
Then I bid you wale.
I'm just gonna let you guys be. I don't wanna fight these guys. I don't think I can fight these guys. Can I talk to you?
Oh, wait. Watch yourself properly.
What the actual frick is this place? I mean, I'm not friends with powder gangers, so I mean, cool, kill them, I don't care. Where am I going? What the actual frick? I'm trying to buy a Novak, I think. I'm supposed to be going to Novak. Find my darling Burke or something. I know Novak. Oh, interesting. Oh, weird. What, are they gonna blow this place up? Cause like, I know one ending of this game. One. And that's literally all the experience I have in this game, outside of Burke. I like Burke. He's interesting. Yeah, she's busy fighting. Bro, you missed all of them. What? That's the one that mattered, apparently. What the actual frick? I'm going back. What? A dunderhead. I don't even know how to disengage it. But... quite literally a dunderhead. Seriously, did they just blow up this town while I was fighting? Dang. Okay. My character looks like the standard character because I did not take 3 seconds in customization, and I changed my character's hair color to be a darker brown. And that was it. Oh, frick.
You like that?
Thank you. I forgot I have high perception in this game. Cumbered? That's not good. Let's just repair some stuff. There's some knives. I'm really over encumbered, huh? Jeez. Metal armor. Dang, that's decent. There. Oh, heck yeah. Okay. There. Whew. Literally. They're all there. The other guys, I got all distracted.
Hold your tongue, Waystrom.
Yep, sorry. Wait, so where am I going now? Novak? That's really far. I think I don't have to cross the path of that. Forget. Of the prison where I'm vilified. Yeah, I'm excited to go to Novak. Somebody walked by my window while I was yelling about shooting heads and whatnot. Well, yelling about murdering people. Kid walked by my window. No, you don't have to. Pando is, it's this little animal character that I have on my starting screen and ending screen and my BRB screen. Actually, let me see if it's on my BRB screen. Yeah, it is. Oh, I kind of see it. So Pando is that little animal creature that sits on the other, on my other drawing screen. That's Pando. Pando's really cool. It's just a, avatar. It has control in chat. So it, like, asks people how they are, it tells you that they're hungry, it tells you, it puts, like, little ZZZs in chat and whatnot. It's really fun. There's some, like channel points you can use. Usually I use them, and like I'll give treats to Pando, I'll give water to Pando and whatnot. He's just a cute little guy to have. He talks to people, he greets people when they join chat and whatnot. It's really cool. I think he's fun. But yeah, I know people can literally ignore him if they want, if y'all want to. You don't have to talk to him, he's not gonna respond. So these guys are and Sierra? Yeah. He gets really happy. Is he doing it right now or no? He's not doing it. The doc says, like, I can only... Yeah, he'll thank you. He says that, every once in a while, there's, like, a rare spot. If I'm hanging out my BRB screen, or in starting or ending, you can, like, if you feed him or do something with him, I don't necessarily know how the games work with him, honestly. But, jeez! Jiminy Crickets! I don't even think I hit that person. What the frick just happened? Like, I don't even have... I'm gonna get drunk. Jaw. Doctor's big. I got a doctor's bag. I got two doctor's bags. Heck yeah. Over, I'm over encumbered again. Freaking. There. I'm like skirting by. I'm trying my hardest. How far am I from Novak? Not that far. I'm skirting by. I got so much junk to sell right now. It is outrageous. Oh, the phone died. Muy triste. And the moment I see that dinosaur, ha! What's this? This friendly? What are you? I touched it. Oh, ranger station? Can I sell here? Please let me sell here. Is there a store here? Charlie? No! Who are you?
When I got this assignment, I was hoping there'd be more gambling.
Heh. Probably. Anyone would hope that. That's sad. At least it's friendly. Cool. Okay. Well, at least we're almost there. Kinda said I'm not friends with the powder gangers anymore, though. That was cool. For a moment. Dude, so I was playing this game. And the dinosaur! Look, it's a dinosaur! The dinosaur! I'm excited! Holy frick! We're almost there, my friends! So, you know what I absolutely love about Novak? Is that, you know how it got its name? It's a motel. Novak is a motel. And, literally, I'll have to show you how they, like, the source of their name. That's absolutely hilarious. Yeah, it's like, there's like a bunch of, like, houses, and then there's like the one motel there. Like, all the locals live around here. Let me see if I can find the front gate. It's absolutely amazing. Who do you sell? Mercenary, hey. Mercenary. Doctor.
What can I do for you?
Can I not trade with you? I need supplies.
Yeah.
Okay. You were the basil bat, the cleaver. I got so much freaking dynamite that I'm not allowing myself to use. A grenade rifle? What? A police baton. Okay. Impacts. Okay. Fire iron, that. Merc. Okay. There.
Thanks.
There, now we're not always over... Yeah!
Bye.
Now we're not over-encumbered. Thank goodness. Yeah. So, it's not necessarily their neon sign. Well, the neon sign is broken. It's the no vacancy. But only Novak survived. That's how they got their names. No vacancy. I think that's hilarious. Motherfucker, you stalker!
Well, butter my butt and call me a biscuit if it ain't my old friend from Good Springs.
What are you doing in Novak?
Don't rightly know. I just got the notion to make my way to New Vegas. Reckon I'll find out when I get there.
I wonder why. What's the story at this place?
Novak? Nice enough place, I suppose. But between you and me, when I rolled into town, my skin started to itch. Watch yourself.
It's nice to see a friendly face out here.
Likewise, friend, likewise. Is there anything old Vic can do you for?
Can I just have him follow me? Wouldn't that be easier on me? Views of Ben some supplies.
Now, this ain't New Vegas, but I reckon you can find what you need here. Try the office out front.
You said men jumped me were heading this way, right?
No, don't believe I did. But you might ask around. The Novak folk usually see anyone traveling this way.
Okay, goodbye.
Be seeing you.
The Dino D Lat front desk. Oop. Dobered up. Okay. Let's go see. Is this a gift shop? The Dino Bite gift shop? Nope. What's up here? Do you actually want me to answer that? Because I do know the answer to that.
God damn it.
But it all depends on how you, like you on want. Who you side with in the end, is kind of the answer to it. Expecting visitors?
Yeah, I guess maybe I am. But not like you.
Food. Huh.
Maybe it should have been you I was expecting all along.
I love you, Boone. Why I actually called here? Him Burke. I'm a Boone. Wanted to check out the view.
I think you better leave.
Just making friendly conversation.
I don't have friends here.
I freaking love Boone. I'm not from here.
No. No, you're not, are you? Maybe you shouldn't go. Not just yet.
Why is that?
I need someone I can trust. You're a stranger. That's a start.
What do you want me to do?
I want you to find something out for me. I don't know if there's anything to find, but I need someone to try. My wife was taken from our home by Legion slavers one night while I was on watch. They knew when to come and what route to take.
He really is.
And they only took Carla. Aww. Someone set it up. I don't know who.
They're trying to track down your wife.
My wife's dead. I want the son of a bitch who sold her.
Oh. What do I do to find the stranger, this person?
Bring him out in front of the nest here while I'm on duty. I work nights. I'll give you my NCR beret to put on. It'll be our signal, so I know you're standing with him. And cool. I'll take care of the rest. I need to do this myself.
I'll see what I can do to help you out.
Good. I'll make it worth your while. And one more thing. We shouldn't speak again. Not until it's over. No one in town knows that I know what happened to my wife. Best they never know. Or the Legion will be after me next.
Oh, I'm so excited. How do you know your wife's dead?
I know, all right. That's all you need to know.
Goodbye.
Yeah.
I've never had where goodbye is the only option to talk to a person. Okay. Hi, Cliff.
Hey there. If you want to buy something from a shop, you'll have to wait till it opens.
I'm looking for a man in a checkered coat. Have you seen anyone?
Sure, but he didn't buy any souvenirs, if that's what you're wondering. Sounded like he didn't have his money with him. His friends seemed disappointed about it. Heck, I would be too if I found such a fine store and left my money elsewhere. Manny might know more about him. Thought he might have been friends with one or two of them. He's up in the dino mouth during the day.
Oh, okay. Goodbye.
Come back soon now.
Okay. But yeah, all I really can say with no spoilers is that Victor, whether if you're trying to figure out if he's good or bad, it truly depends on who you're working with.
Hey, Manny. What's going on, man?
Who are you?
I'm Manny. I'm on security detail here. You see a rifle barrel sticking out of the dinosaur's mouth, you got a 50-50 shot it's me. Otherwise, it's Boone.
Who do you protect the town from?
You name it. Anything that comes within 1,000 yards that looks like trouble. Lately, we've been getting ghouls, coming from the road to Repcon out to the west. Quite a few last couple days. The big threat is the Legion coming from the east. If they decide to attack with a full force, they'll run us over. But so far, we've been lucky.
Okay. I'm looking for a man in a checkered coat.
Sure, I know him. What do you want with him?
I have a score to settle.
Doesn't surprise me. Guy seemed like he'd do whatever it takes to get what he wants. Probably makes a lot of enemies. Well, listen, I can definitely help you find him, but I've got problems of my own. Maybe we can do a trade. You need my help.
Oh, no, not...
something I need, too.
It kind of. It's not in my apartment. So... So, fun fact about where I live. I live in an apartment building, yes. However, next door to the apartment building is a brewery. And on Friday nights, they have live music. And my window's open. And I share the... Well, the brewery's like 50 feet from me. So I can hear the live music. And whenever someone's talking, I hear the music more than I'm hearing them talk. And I start, like, just dancing to it. So that's all that's going on. But yeah. What do you need?
Novak, it's home for me now.
It's awesome. Good. It's freaking amazing.
And I've left too many homes behind. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't have anything to trade. They'd all have to leave. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site. But a bunch of ghouls showed up one day and took it over. We can't get in there now.
Why don't you deal with it?
I would, but I've got to watch the road. Caesar's Legion has been taking territory just east of here. They took Nelson. If we let our guard down, they might attack. All it takes for the Legion is for them to sense weakness.
Oh, but yeah, the live music is this, like, local band. So, like, not even that's, like, big known. It's just some guy who comes by, he plays his guitar and just sings some songs. It's really cool, actually. What needs to be done?
Well, they gotta go. Or this will be a ghost town.
So if you catch me dancing, it's easy because there's live music out my window.
What you do. As long as the ghouls are out of there, that's good enough for me.
Okay, I'll see what can be done.
It'd mean a lot to me.
Who's Boone?
Boone's a sniper, same as me. Used to spot for him when we were enlisted with the NCR. After we got out, I talked him into settling down here.
It so is here usually are. Either, classic rock. So he flips between classic rock and country. Tonight's classic rock. Sometimes he does requests, and when he does requests, unfortunately, that's when country comes out. But he picks like classic rock in his own rights. But I don't specifically know what the song he's playing off the top of my head. Why are you on bad terms with Boone?
Me and his wife, we didn't see eye to eye on some things. We had some pretty big arguments. One day, she turns up missing, and he hasn't said a word to me since.
They're both very solid genres. I prefer classic rock or alternative country. Is like he, like, people around here request, like, strong country, like, Turner kind of stuff. Well, not necessarily Turner, because I do listen to Turner. But it's like, you know, Turner's, like, as close to alternative as he'll get for locals. But it's like, I don't necessarily hate country, I just don't pick it. What'd you guys argue about?
Man, you name it. See, I grew up in North Vegas, me and my cousins. We were some bad seeds. Got in with a gang, I loved it. Then something happened and I couldn't handle it anymore. So I enlisted, earned my future, brought down my best friend to share that future with me. And here was this woman who was too good for it, trying to take him away. So yeah, I didn't see eye to eye with the bitch.
Do you have anything to do with his wife's disappearance?
Believe me, When I heard the news, my first thought was, I owe somebody big. I figured Boone would come around after a while. But he hasn't. I'm starting to think that if he doesn't find her, things will never go back to the way they were.
Who would want to hurt his wife?
Man, everybody. That girl didn't have one friend in this whole town. She didn't want any. She wanted to sit in her room all day and make herself miserable, and she went out of her way to be rude. She upset a lot of people. You wouldn't have liked her either.
Okay. Goodbye. I want some more evidence. However, that does not sound very promising. Haunt hospitality. Man, you made the right choice putting us up to keeping it quiet. This weasel Betty has been twitchy since we stole that package from his boss, making me nervous as hell. But when I found out we'd be passing through on our way to Boulder City, I was sure we could count on you. Let the other cons say what they want, but I know where your loyalty is. One day you'll remember where you belong. Your brothers and sisters will welcome you back like you never left. You know where to find us. McMurphy. Okay. Send someone. Anybody. I want to send Manny. That's who I want to send. Traveling merchant? Oh, okay.
Prim.
Daisy.
Fine weather for flying. It's times like these that make me miss it all.
You were a pilot?
Vertibird pilot. Oh. 71 missions and only lost one chopper. Rotor malfunction over Klamath. Hard landing, but I walked away.
Okay. Did you fly for NCR?
Four? No, not exactly. It was a long time ago. Things are a lot different these days, and those days are way behind me.
So, normally, I would say give, like, my little 12-minute warning or whatever. I usually do 17, but, I'm gonna go until we figure out what happened to Boone's wife, is what we're gonna be doing. And it's probably gonna take longer than 12 minutes. What are you doing, Novak?
I help folks strip down the more complicated bits of salvage they bring in. Engines, mostly.
So, at least a 12-minute warning.
The bits and pieces we take out are usually worth more than the whole thing put together.
Yeah, Tano got a little tight after that feast. Man, Tano needs a nap.
Watch your six.
Motel room? Anybody staying here? Ew. Nope. Take that. Okay. Nothing in here. Doesn't like one of these rooms like become ours or something? Bruce.
Oh, please don't kill me. I swear I'll have... Wait. You don't work for Mr. Bishop, do you?
No. What would make you think that?
Sorry, it's just... You look like his type, you know? You got that hard-ass wasteland explorer thing going on.
Aren't you that singer from New Reno? I think I saw you play the clubs there.
Oh, so you have heard of me. Yeah, that's right. I was the big draw at the Shark Club. People used to pay hundreds of caps to see me.
Why did you come all this way?
You don't know Mr. Bishop. He's not like other bosses up there. He knows the wasteland like the back of his hand, and he likes to wander it. I knew if I didn't get way the hell away from New Reno, he'd run me down like a dog.
Man, do you know how long it took me to realize it's a bolo and not a bobo tie? Uncomfortable many years of that. Oh, but yeah, 100%. No, this dude's giving, leader of the Thieves Guild, the guy who, like, recruits you. That's 100% the face he's giving. Yeah. Why? Ugh, Frick, and my phone's dead. Yeah, Bobo. Apparently, freaking Automod grabbed it, but yeah. My phone's dead, so I can't approve it. But yeah, it was a Bobo tie. Well, I was like, why would Bishop be after you?
Oh, well, that's all just a big misunderstanding, see? Mr. Bishop, well, he owed me a lot of money.
Sucker and idiot before, you know, so I don't think it meant anything,
so I
honestly. I need to make a note to do that. My auto mod's kind of stupid lately. I think Twitch did an update to it, and it got reset. So I have to go back in and just make it not. But yeah. No, it was like I watched Wizards of Waverly Place, and like the principal wears a bolo tie all the time. And the amount of times I heard bolo, my ears got confused, I guess, and I just started hearing bobo tie. And then I was like, oh, okay, it's a bobo tie. And someone corrected me when I was in Texas at age of 18. Freaking, I got corrected 6 years ago, almost seven. Freaking, it was awkward. I was about to graduate high school when I got corrected. You robbed a casino, boss?
Robbed is such an ugly word. It's more like I took care of a payroll problem for him. Also, I might have, sort of plowed his daughter. A little.
Well, hats off to you. That takes some balls, man.
Thanks. But if Bishop finds me and I don't have his money, my balls are going to be on his trophy wall.
Yeah, I'll go through tonight and I'll loosen that. Because it's getting a little bit much and I'm playing old games and I can't, like, flip back and forth. My entire computer locks up when I do that, so I'm gonna loosen it tonight. I'll let you know if I find any work for a singer.
You do that?
Great. Yeah. No.
I really appreciate that.
I do get slight entertainment out of the things it flags, though.
Yeah. See you later.
Okay. Okay. So he got nothing for me. Motel room. That's my motel room. Okay. We gotta go ask the locals, I guess, about Boone's wife to see if nobody else liked her. If somebody did like her. Really? I hear it tastes like iguana. Door to Novak House. Settler, you're not people. You're not gonna talk to me. However, I do want to try alligator at some point. However, I imagine that also tastes the same. McBride? Hey!
What brings you here?
Asking questions. What can you tell me about Boone's wife?
Boone. That's that sniper fella. Works in the dinosaur, right?
Yeah, I heard it's pretty good. It's just a little dry. But
they seemed real happy together. I really ought to get to know them better. They're probably nice folk.
So she doesn't know. I just wanted to meet you.
Oh, well, I'm Alice, and that handsome stranger yonder is my husband, Dusty.
Yonder?
Going on 50 years now.
Oh, cute.
I keep waiting for him to leave me for some young thing with platinum blonde hair and hoop earrings, but he still sticks around. Says it's my cooking. I think it's because I know which Brahmin udder you can milk without getting kicked in the noggin.
That's important to know. No, I do like trying wacky foods, but... Oh, 100%. They're terrifying. But like, I want to go like on a weird... on a food around the world tour thing. Or like a food around the US tour, maybe? and just try like really weird things. Let's get out of here.
Nice of you to visit.
What about you, Yonder?
Things treating you all right?
We can talk about Boone's wife.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't really know them two as well as I might. I remember she had an edge about her, like she'd rather be someplace else. This kind of life ain't for everyone. That's for darn sure.
That's fair.
But, so long.
Yeah. It was like, I know, I've tried weird things in Ecuador. I've tried, I mean, it wasn't necessarily interesting, but I had some pretty, I tried a decent amount of weird dishes in Thailand, but they weren't necessarily weird. It was just like, I didn't know you could do so many weird things with octopus. And if you say, oh, that's not normal for Thailand, the rivers say otherwise. I went kayaking in a river in Thailand and got a couple of octopi stuck to our kayak. They were so cute. Who are you? Stop walking. I can't run.
Prim has a new sheriff. That should keep the powder.
Yeah, is this another Novak house? It is. Okay. Ooh, what about that? I like this shack. But... oh, they're tiny. Here. There, I had... what the mother frick did I just walk into? I'm sorry, mannequins hit me a little weird. So, this is a standard 16-ounce water bottle that's in my hand. They would, one of them lived in a water bottle like this, and like, its body took up, when it was like crunkled up, took up about that much of the water bottle. And like, the other one was like maybe a little bit bigger, but they all the octopi I saw fit in this water bottle. They're all cute little river octopi.
What? How'd you get-
Hey! Hi, Nobark.
Who sent you?
They're just little guys. You could hold them in your hand.
Before, but I didn't say nothing, and I don't aim to now, by gum.
I don't mean harm.
We'll just see about that. You come any
closer, they're so cute.
I'm liable to
heel
stick
weird, though.
You with my sticking knife. Old Stick is feeling mighty ornery this day.
They feel like if you ever peeled up like road tar on a hot day because you were just bored. They feel like road tar, just you know. With suction cups. It's weird. We can talk from this distance.
You sure now? It's kind of...
you said you'd stab me with that dirty... glare.
Okay, okay. Just speak up a little. Not so much that they hear you. They got people everywhere. Always listening.
Why do they call you No Bark?
Because they know I ain't just barking here. What I say is got bite. Cause it's the truth.
Out by
them
Wall Street.
Doctors
heck
can
yeah.
Say what they want about all the rad scorpion stings that done pierced my skull. I know what I seen.
I also saw like a kimono dragon while I was kayaking. It was really weird. I don't even know if it was supposed to be there or if it was someone's pet. But yeah, it was like hanging up by the river. It was cute. Do you know about the abduction of Boone's wife?
Seen it all. Seen shadowy folk come to his room and leave again in the middle of the night. Thought one might have gone in the lobby too for a spell. Could be that person went in to get something. Or used the john, maybe. Mighty interesting either way, you ask me. I thought it was cannibals, come to eat us all for sure. So I kept out of sight. But now I know better.
Who was it?
More rat men. Come up from the underneath to steal young women with promises of riches and fancy mud mansions with all the latest designer appliances. They covered our lady folks' long hair for wigs, it said, being either bald or balding themselves.
Also, the Komodo dragon thing I saw was it wasn't like being weird, I don't think. However, it might have been cleaning its teeth on a tree. It was a little weird. I'm gonna go. Okay, so we're gonna go into that office. Check the office terminal, I think. Lizards are frickin'. Watching reptiles eat is kinda. Ugh. Like, watching their, like, jaws unhinge gets a little creepy. Front disc. Hi. Hey, Jenny.
Well, welcome to you. You look tired from the road. Why don't you relax a
spell? Why do you think this was an abandoned room?
Let this fine town take care of you.
Tell me about Boone's wife.
How should I put it? I guess you could say she was kind of like a cactus flower. Real pretty to look at, but there was just no getting close to her. She never did take to living here. She liked the big lights and fast living of New Vegas. I got the feeling she was trying to get Boone to live with her, but I guess she got tired of waiting.
Man, I used to make coloring books. I'd try to make coloring books, aka I'd do line drawings of like weird animals I've seen that I saw on TV. And it turned into the Picasso version of like Phineas and Ferb. Like, it was freaking weird. What's wrong with Boone?
Nothing that wouldn't be wrong with any man who loses a wife, I suppose. Poor dear. I know he thinks she was kidnapped, but I'm not so sure she didn't just run off on her own. You could tell she was thinking about it ever since they arrived.
We haven't met yet.
Oh, what am I doing? I got to thinking about making a good impression and plain forgot to tell you my name. I'm Jeannie May. I take care of folks here at the motel, long as they aren't troublemakers.
Okay. What? Okay, I'm confused. Welcome to Mojave Express. Dropbox. Express Mojave Dropbox. Express Dropboxes, my gosh. Like this one, can be used to deliver items to any Mojave Express Dropbox that you've discovered. Once you find a Mojave Express Dropbox, just activate it and you'll be able to use that location to send and receive items. What the fuck? Okay. My head hurts a little bit on that one.
How you doing?
Hi, Boone. Hi,
welcome to the Dino.
Can you tell me about Boone's wife?
Can't say we spoke much. Boone did most of the buying for him. She was in the store once, but she didn't stay long. Had a look on her face like she'd smelled something sour. But far as I can remember, the gift shop smelled fine. Well, fine as it always does.
Okay.
Come back soon.
So nobody really knew her. Cool. Man. Why are there dinosaurs? Why are there dinosaurs everywhere? There are so many freaking dinosaurs in here. Don't you just hate when you turn your head and suddenly look back and Pepsi's staring at you? What? So many other freaking dinosaurs! How many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 dinosaurs! Why are there 27 dinosaurs? I'm afraid I'm gonna find 28 hidden somewhere. In like a chair or something. Is there a dinosaur in here? There's not a dinosaur in there. Thank goodness there's only 27. My gosh. That dude has an addiction. Andy. Andy.
We haven't met yet. You must be new in town. I'm Andy.
What can you tell me about Boone's wife?
Carla was a knockout. Whenever Boone walked around with her, he always had this funny grin on his face like he couldn't believe his luck. I know we couldn't. That wasn't the only reason she stuck out, though. That girl never minced words. If she'd had better food or hospitality, she'd let you hear it. Trouble was, she usually had. I don't think she meant it. She really was a sweet girl. I think she just wanted to remind herself that there's still nicer places in this world than Novak.
It's so sad.
Who could blame her for that?
You're with the NCR, right?
Was with them. That was back when my arm and leg used to work better. I still like to pretend I'm a ranger, though. I'll check in with the guys up at the station pretty regular on the ham radio. Sometimes they stop by, tell me they're paying their respects, the smug bastards. They haven't been responding to me last couple days. I guess they got tired of hearing me talk, but it still got me a little worried. Hell, listen to me talk, like some damn mother hen.
Would you feel better if I checked on your friends?
No. They're gonna think I'm having trouble letting go. They're good soldiers. I don't give them enough credit.
Okay. What's wrong with Boone?
Had his wife taken.
Oh.
I don't think he'll ever be the same as he was. Damn shame. I told the Rangers up at the station to keep an eye out, but there's just too much ground out there for them to cover.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna go.
Hey,
Wait, I was there. We could go do that real quick. Get a little distraction from looking for Boone's wife. However, I'm pretty sure I know who did it. Person who had the most to say. I feel like I know who did it. Well, I'm gonna not be here anymore. I have regrets in life. That was awful. Jeez. Okay, let's go talk to Andy about that. That was terrible.
Howdy.
Hi.
Brim wimped out and accepted NCR rule. Some people feel safe.
I went out and accepted it, motherfricker.
Any word on Station Charlie?
Everyone there was wiped out.
What?
I saw a lot of dead rangers.
God damn it. I just spoke. Nah, that'd be too far. Even for those guys. Listen, this could be trouble for all of us. Whoever did this is still out there.
There were a lot of it yesterday.
If you can find out who did this, we can be better prepared to deal with them if they come through here.
Right. Man.
Look out for yourself.
I didn't think they'd all be dead. That's awful. Okay. Yeah. I feel like he's hiding something. Why can't I sit in his? Oh, did not mean to do that. However, he's a con, so I kind of want it to be him. So we're gonna. I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna do it. I don't like him. Where's Boone's spray? Okay. I'm gonna kill Manny. So we're gonna wait a couple of hours. Then we're gonna take Manny with us and we're gonna go get him shot in the head. Wherever he is. What was that? Manny up here? That's Manny. idea, but he works with the cons.
I'm counting on you.
What? Wait, what?
Yeah.
I can't take him with me? Is it because I have a mission? Is it because I have his mission? I have no idea, honestly. I've never even done this mission, honestly. So, like, I kind of just want to... grab a sucker and just do it. Hey, Manny.
You have any luck with the ghouls?
No, but will you come with me? What was I supposed to do again? Oh, yeah, there we go.
What?
There it goes. Okay. Okay. What is this holotape? Check on that, yeah. Seriously. When did that stop being like a notes app? Busted radio? That's rude. Whatever. That was really quick. How did he? We were both wearing the same beret. How would he have known? Motherfucker could have just shot me in the head.
That's it then.
His story didn't add up.
You didn't have any.
It's the closest proof that there was.
God damn it, this wasn't supposed to be a. Get out.
What? There's never gonna be proof!
Get the hell away. We're done talking.
No! Yeah, I know. Whatever. I don't care. Whatever. Yeah. Really, I remember it being Manny. Mostly because he worked for the cons. And that was his it. Because it was the cons that took him and he was the thing. But I could not find any of his information. But yeah. Oh well. Meh. Where was the information, though? Look at the fact he has, like, weird stains on his floor. Meh. I'll probably find out later who it actually was then. Yeah, Manny was weird to me, though. But... I don't even know what her... No, she didn't have anything on her that way. This is... Wait, this is her room? Wait. I want to check something. I mean, if anything, I'll just load up on my own time and go and correct it. Wait. Yeah, okay. Bill of sale. That's what I was missing. Okay. Bill of sale. Console Genie. Purchase from Genie May. Oh. So Genie May was the right person. Okay. Hold on, I'm just gonna off stream load it up and just do kill her then. I seriously thought it was Manny. Granted, friggin', I don't have any loads. I'm gonna be doing it off stream because I don't have any loads from here, I don't think. No. That's like right now. But yeah. I am officially 3 hours and 10 minutes into this. And I am actually unfortunately calling it finally, since now we killed a unfortunate person. And I am now 18 minutes over stream. But yeah. Howdy fate. That's so sad. Why did I remember being Manny? Not that I remember. I always thought it was Manny. However, I had friends kill him before too, so I mean. Whoops. But we're gonna definitely be calling it here, because I gotta get stuff done. So. Jeez. But thank you guys so much for watching my very technically blind playthrough of Fallout New Vegas. Hopefully I'm going to be touching on this again later, but I'm definitely going to... this is mirrored. Actually, this chat, this window itself is mirrored. And I have such a hard time with it. So I get used to this. This is the perfect mirror for me. And then the other one's flipped, which kind of sucks. But yeah. But yeah. Makes it easier. Wait, Chachi, how long have you been here, dude? But yes, so that was my first time playing Fallout New Vegas, and hopefully I will be playing it again soon. That was a lot of fun. But I will definitely go back and fix that, so Manny will not be dead, unfortunately. So I can have Boone, because I need Boone. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys on Wednesday. Oh, next week is interesting. My schedule's interesting next week, I just remembered. I'm streaming 2 days in a row next week. I am streaming on Wednesday, and I am streaming on Thursday, because my work schedule is weird. But I will see you guys next week, Wednesday, 4 p.m. Why is this so delayed? I'll see you guys next week on Wednesday. Depending on whatever I'm in the mood for, either we'll be doing Morrowind or we'll be doing a little bit more of this, depending. But I will see you guys then. And until then, be good, behave, stay out of trouble, and/or don't get caught. And I will catch you guys next time. My computer's working again. I see it like pop up in my notifications, and like I sit there, I'm like, okay, 3, 2, 1, it's gonna go, and it's like 30 seconds later, it's like, oh, okay. But anyways, I'll see you guys next time.